Okay, student, today we will discuss another database object that is indexes. Indexes in databases. Previously, we discussed few other database objects in Oracle or in databases. Those objects are we have a view, sequence, synonyms. Here, we discuss the concept of the view in databases. Sequences and databases, then identity columns, and then synonyms. And we already discussed the concept of creation of the table in databases. So, what is the indexes? Indexes are the database object that can create to improve the performance of any query. So, to improve the performance of the query, in a databases, we have to create the indexes. Index can be created automatically by the server whenever we have to create the or whenever we have to assign the primary key to any column. So, what is the index? That is a schema object. That is a database object. Index is a database object. That can be used by the Oracle servers or even SQL Server, MySQL or any other DBMS, which speed up the retrieval of the row by using a pointer. Indexes reduce the disk IO operations by using the rapid path access method to locate the data quickly. When we see that we are having the concept of the index, user can create index. Creation of the index are performed by the two method, indexes. We are having the two methods are there. First one is automatically. First one method is automatically, and second one we have a manually. First one is automatically and second one is a manually. When we see that automatically, it's mean that index will be a unique index that is created automatically when user define a primary key or unique constraint in a table definitions. When user have to assign the primary key or unique constraints. To any columns, then what will be happen? Index will be automatically created. So those unique index, the server automatically create the index for the primary key columns or a unique constraint columns. And we have to assign the name of the index. The name of index is the name of the given constraints. If we are assigning any names for the primary key or unique constraints, so that will be assigned to the name of the index. While if user is not assigning any names for the constraints, then the DBMS will automatically assign any names. The name of the index must be unique. So when we see that we have a unique index, though that is created automatically on the primary key columns, or second one we are having the unique constraint columns. Second one we are having the non-unique constraint index or manually created index. User have to create non-unique index on the columns. Why? Because to speed up the data. For the fast retrieval of the data, user have to create the index. Like if we want to improve the performance, for improvement of the performance, we have to create the index. So when we here, these index are created implicitly by the user. sorry, these manually index, these are the created by the user, while the automatic index, these are the explicitly whenever we have to assign the primary key. Now how we can create the index? Creation of the index, what is the method? So we have a query create, we have the two options are there. First one is unique, or we have second one, that is a bitmap index. We can use unique keywords or bitmap, both of these keywords are optional. So we have to use the create unique or bitmap and index, name of index, any name we can assign to the index. On then we have mentioned the table names, and then we have to mention the list column names or list of the column names. That's all. That is the procedure to create the index. So we may have a unique index, or we may have the bitmap index. When we are specifying the unique to indicate that the value of the column or the columns upon which the index is based must be unique. The value assigned to the column, that all of those value must be unique. While whenever we have to specify the bitmap, the for that one the index is to be created with a bitmap for each distinct key rather than indexing each row separately. Bitmap index store the row ID associated with the key as a bitmap. So we have to create the index using the two way, that may be a unique index, or we may have an index that is a bitmap index. So how we may be able to create it? Let see it over here. We are using the Oracle 19c. So here we can create the index. We are already connected with the HR users. So we want to create the index on the first name columns or last name columns, any columns, right? And now we want to create it, and we want to create the manual index. So how we can create it over here? So we have to write the create index and name of index. We can use it over here. We said it's a employee lost names index, create index, name of index. Name of index must be unique. On we said that we have to mention the table's name. Table names, let me say that implies, and we have to assign the column names. On which one columns? We see that we have a lost name. We created the index over here on the columns lost name in imply table. Now if we have to create the value from the lost names, it will take the value from the database and fastly retrieve the values. So here we are using the row ID that will be associated with the columns, that DBMS will automatically generate the row ID that will associate the column lost names, and then value can fastly retrieve from the database. So that is the basic procedure that how we may be able to use the index. So creation of the index, that's very easy process. Simply we have to use the create index, name of index, on table name and then column name. Now we are having some guidelines for creation of index, when we have to create the index and when not. So index creation, when create index. So we see that a column contains a wide range of the values. Whenever we are having any column is given having the massive amount of the data, large volume of the data, so then we have to create the index on that column. Wide range of values in a column. Second one, we say that column contains a large number of null values. Column may contain large number of null values, absence of the values, values are not given. So whenever we have a for key column, on that one column we may have the maximum values or the missing, then we can use the index. And we have to use the index on those column that are frequently accessed by the users, and those columns used together in the where clause are in a joint condition. So all of those columns that are accessed very frequently, so on those columns we have to frequently accessed by the users, right, and a where clause are in a join conditions. So in where clause or we are using the joins, and those columns are used for the joins even in the where clause. So whenever we are having the query is there that contain the large volume of the data, like most of the queries, whenever we have to retrieve the data, and if retrieval of the data is less than 2% or even up to 4%, then we may be able to create the index on the columns. If we are having the index columns contains more than 4% of the data, then we don't need to create the index. So here we are having the different way that are different guidelines when we have to create the index. We say that we are having the wide range of the values in a columns, then we have to create the index may contain the large number of the null values. Similarly, we say that whenever we say that we are having the column that contain a distinct values, then create the index frequently access in the where clause. The table is very large, and the most the queries are expected to retrieve less than 2% of the data, whenever 2% or even 4% of the data, less than 2% or even 4% of the rows in the tables. Then we have to create the index. Never create the index on those columns that so we see that never create the index on those columns that are not often used on the condition in the queries. So the column that are not used in the conditions, then no need to create index on such columns. Whenever we say that we are having the table is small, then no need to create the index, right? The when table is small, or even we are using the queries that retrieve the data more than 2 to 4% of the data, mean retrieval of the data that contains the large volume of the data, then never create the index. Similarly, whenever we are having, when we say that more than 4% of data or large volume of the data is retrieved by a query from the table, then never use the index. Similarly, we see that when table is updated very frequently, third one is updated very frequently, then never create the index. If we are creating the index on the such columns that is updated very frequently, then it's mean that after the updation of the data that will be recreated, that instead of improving the performance, that hurts the performance. So these are the different way that different guidelines that when we have to create the index and when we not have to create the index. As we say that index is used to improve the performance. So the advantages of the index is improve performance. While disadvantage, if you see that it take, when we have to create the index, so it take extra storage space to manage the value. So that's why when we need the index, whenever we have a large volume of the data, then create index. If data is not updated very frequently, then create the index. So that is the procedures, and these are the advantages and disadvantages related to the index. Now last point, that is how to remove or drop the index. So we are having the queries to drop the index, drop index and name of index. So we may be able to drop or remove the index from the database. Let me write the queries over here for the dropping, to drop the index, drop index, name of index. We are having the name of index is imply last names index, so we can write it over here. In this way we may be able to drop the index from the databases. So create index and drop index can be performed in databases. So all of these concepts are related to the index, that how we may be able to create index and drop index. Thanks for watching the video.